Something's got a hold on me lately. No, I don't know myself anymore. Feels like the walls are all closing in and the devil's knocking at my door. Whoa, out of my mind. How many times did I tell you I'm no good at being alone? Yeah, it's taking a toll on me. Trying my best to keep from tearing the skin off my bones. Don't you love me? I want your body like a fiend, like a bad habit. Bad habits hard to break when I'm with you. Yeah, I know I can do it on my own, but I want that real full moon, black magic, and it takes two. Problematic. Problem is when I'm with you, I'm an addict. And I need some relief. My skin and your teeth can't see the forest through the trees. Got me down on my. Something's got a hold on me lately. No, I don't know myself anymore.
Lose Control, you know, we knew that song was really gonna change my life. I just felt it. And I never really had felt like that much before, you know, where he's like, oh, this is gonna work.
How many times did I tell you I'm no good at being alone?
My good pal Ammo, Julian Brunetta, and Mickey Echo wrote on that song with me. And we're in a camp, and a little writing camp for about 4 days with a bunch of folks. And I was kind of going through a lot with the person I was dating at the time. And so Ammo had the beat of it, you know, and had like produced it forever ago. And so when he came with, but Julian was like, he had this idea in the whole camp. He was like, I just want to, like, before we leave, like, we got to write this song. Because he was like, I want it to be like, I lose control. just do like a crazy little Teddy run, like it's gonna be, because we wanted to kind of go for something that was like, I guess the same feeling you get from like a Tennessee Whiskey by Chris Stapleton, you know, there's just that one kind of intricate run, and when somebody sings it at a karaoke bar, they're playing, you know, at the restaurant, and they're playing acoustic, and they sing that song, it really kind of grabs you in from the very first line of the song, because, you know, when you're waiting on that moment to see if that person is going to hit that run, and it is like, and if you can't, then just don't even bother singing it. Mickey Echo came in on the second verse and just wrote the absolute hell out of it, and he's just a genius, man, just an absolute genius. There's nothing wrong with that man can do. He's just a weird thinker too, and just an absolute, one of the sweetest, most beautiful people I love to death. Man, that dude is an absolute weirdo, you know, but like just mentally, he's just on a different playing field than everyone else. He's an alien, man. He really is a robot. I hope when people listen to that song that they feel like there's somebody there that went through that, and that addiction is a hard thing, you know, and just there's a way to separate and there's a way to get out of it. You can love somebody so much, but sometimes you guys just aren't good together, you know, and so I found that like it really became like the substance of the relationship was really like what the substances we were abusing at the time, you know, and we kind of like built this lifestyle of the ways we were partying or acting, and it just made like, when of course you're in that world with somebody, it's so highs, you know, but the lows were just very, very rough, and it's hard to get out of that situation when you're in it. And, you know, I would let her shatter my heart again. It's just paying the bills, baby, you know what I mean? When we were writing and producing on the song The Door, Ammo just played a big mumble track down and had pretty much all the melodies figured out with just no words on it. And so we kind of sat down and, you know, and had a few tequilas and, you know, just try to write the words to those melodies, which is sometimes like a great way to do it. But I heard the chorus of it, it just like that kind of just came to me that, you know, tonight I saved my life when I showed you the door, and it, this kind of bike was about, again, getting out of that awful situation and knowing that there's a way out, and you just have to decide, and it's hard with abuse when you're in that situation to feel like there's a way out of it, you know. But tonight I saved my life when I showed you the door. It was quite weird because I was still in that thing at the time, like in that relationship, and sometimes when you're in stuff like that, you know, like I didn't know I was writing this song. I would even go home to her and she's like, "What is this about?" You know, and it was like, you know, I it's like not something you want to show that person, like. But I didn't think that I was really there though. You know, that just fell out so freely of my mouth. And it was something I was writing, and a lot of that stuff I was writing, I didn't know that I was going through that. I think I was just kind of numbing myself at the time, and my heart was trying to say stuff to me, and I just wasn't there for myself at all that whole time, you know. And now when I look back at the album after I'm on the other side of that situation, it's quite crazy, because it's like I was trying to tell myself that whole time. My little heart was just working it so hard to try to give me what I needed to hear, and I just was like not even taking my own advice there, and I didn't know that was even really happening to me, and it's just great to hear it now and say, like, what were you thinking, man? Why were you just doing that to yourself? And, but here we are. You know, it's really kind of like a I Will Survive or something, you know what I mean? It's like, I love, like, it just gives me that kind of feeling, that old nostalgic feeling, and just that, like, I'm here for myself, I'm showing up for myself, you can't stop me, you can't hold me back anymore. And I think, yeah, it's like, again, like dark, but very uplifting, I think, and positive in a way, and positive in a super negative light, if that makes sense. Hey, it's Teddy Swims, and I'm about to push play. I think a song that's really special to me that reminds me of being young, I'd have to go with Take Cover by Acceptance. That band just kind of really was the first, that whole album was really the first thing that made me want to be a musician or a singer. Yeah, when we're going out with friends, we had this thing where, and we did it one night, and it turned out to be a really, really rough time. But we started playing The Boys Are Back in Town, and right there in the instrumental break, every time somebody would play The Boys Are Back in Town, it was our cue to all run straight to the kitchen and take another shot. So now every time that song comes on, we all have a little bit of PTSD from it, but we still listen to it. When we're not about to go out or we're about to hit the bar or something, that's the pregame song. It's just The Boys Are Back in Town on repeat until we get hammered to call the Uber. If I had to say a song by an artist that I wish I would have wrote, there is a song by a good friend of mine, and I'm such a huge fan of this guy, Mac Ayers. The song's called Change Your Mind, and it's just, God, when I was first broken up with, that was like, that song got me through a lot, and it's a song still I can find it. It's kind of hard to listen to, you know, but I'm so jealous of it. There's this song a good friend of mine and I've been talking to, this girl Ray, she lives in Atlanta, and I've been listening to her for a couple years, and we've just gotten really close. But there's a song on her album called Loveland, on her album Loveland. I've been obsessed with her, and it just also just makes me feel like, you know, close to her too when I hear it, and she's the best. When I feel in love, yeah, there's always this old song by Frank Sinatra called That Song. He's incredible. But I think just Frank Sinatra in general just makes me feel like I'm in love. He's the best. He's the best at being in love. You know what I will say after a breakup, though? I will go with, I Can't Make You Love Me, you know? God, just Bonnie Raitt. Man, that's like the most beautiful song ever written. I really do believe it's the most beautiful song ever written by anyone. I'm also another song I'm jealous of as well. There's a song called Keep It Alive by Issues, and they're like super metalcore, but kind of pop and R&B. My good friend Tyler Carter was singing for him, and God, that's a song I would crank up that's all the way in my car any moment. My go-to karaoke song, I always will sing, Man, What's Going On by Marvin Gaye. You know, you just get them right in. Now, that's a good one. My favorite throwback track, man, because I was in this band for a while, right before Teddy Swims was, and we were doing a bunch of 60s soul covers and stuff and playing, and I would love to sing, just always love to sing Mr. Pitiful by Otis Redding, and he's incredible. He's his best. The song that makes me get up and dance, and it's my favorite song, and it was for our whole last year's tour, it was kind of our walkout, like, you know, the song right before we walk out, and it's Two Live Crews, Hey We Want Some. Yeah, my dad used to always play that song when I go to his house on the weekends and stuff, and when I was younger, and he was like, dude, just please do not repeat this to your mother. Do not go home. I don't even think I knew what that was at the time, but I knew he was laughing about it, so I loved it. It just felt wrong to say that word. So I was just in the car with him, just yelling it at the top of my lungs, and he was just like, please do not. Do not go home and repeat this.
Ain't no breaking my heart, baby. You make a mess of me.
I ended up going to get my first tattoo, face tattoo. It says Home at Last, to kind of commemorate him, just to kind of like, I guess, like make him mad one more time. Like if heaven exists and maybe he's gonna give me a whooping again, you know what I mean? Hey MTV, it's Teddy Swims, and this is Under the Covers. Covering songs for a long time, I think it's very pivotal to do. I learned a lot from doing it, and it kind of also, I think, helped me guide what I was trying to be, or to keep myself as open-ended as I possibly could be. If I had to name a couple songs that I think really affected my life in a way, I Can't Make You Love Me, I think it's still the most beautiful song in the world, and being able to cover that song did a lot for me. And obviously, Let Me Love You by Mario. How do you make a cover your own? I truly believe that your voice is your one piece of thing that's truly yours, and nobody can sound like you, and nobody sounds like you. I think anybody that sings anything just puts their own signature on it. When I'm in the studio, my must-haves, I don't need too much. I think what's beautiful about writing music is that we could just stand here together with like just our voices and kind of just from thin air create something that never existed that now kind of becomes immortalized in a way on recording. I am gonna say that I drink tequila to write. It's not a must-have because that sounds problematic. It does help a lot to have it. I think it just kind of gets my self out of the way of my brain, you know, and I can just kind of yell freely and have a drink or six, you know. Doing the covers, it really helped me be very open-ended and hear one side of the spectrum to the other and utilize all those tools in that a little toolbox to start creating and writing. And then having people now cover my songs is, I think, the most justifying thing. And the word is just justified, I feel. I was so terrified for a long time to get stuck in covers. You hear just amazing people singing the absolute hell out of your songs, and you're just like, God, that was a good song after all. And me and all my crew, we had this thing that my theater teacher, Mr. Talton, taught us was, we always like kind of, everybody goes and does a pinky promise to each other that everything's gonna go okay. And we all have our own little things that we've added to it. And so now you have to memorize like 40 of those things, and everybody has their own versions of it. It's really cool. And you know, again, I'll say I like to drink tequila. It's really, really good. I think one of my favorite collaborations I've gotten the chance to do is working with Thomas Rhett was just one of the coolest things ever. And I got a chance also to write on his song, Angels Don't Always Have Wings. And that was like, for me, my first song that I ever got to like write and put out for an artist that wasn't me singing on. Working with Meghan Trainor too is just like, I can't say enough about how incredible of a person that she is. My grandfather was a Pentecostal pastor, and so when I was growing up, you know, when I first started getting tattoos, he had told me, just don't get my face tattooed. And when he passed away, I was with my grandmother, and my whole family was over at their house, and she looked up to the sky and said, like, you know, he's home at last. He's home at last. And then she said, but you left me behind, and started crying about it. And I held her in my arms, and I ended up going to get my first tattoo, face tattoo that says home at last, to kind of commemorate him, just to kind of like, I guess like make him mad one more time, like if heaven exists and maybe he's gonna give me a whooping again, you know what I mean? I love him so much, he's my hero, but you know, just kind of like, look, I waited till you died, man. I'm getting my face tattooed now. Stay grounded, you know, I'm my daddy's son, you know, and he's taught me how to be a good person. I'm very fortunate that the guys I have in my band and all my crew are just, they're there for me, and they worry about me, and they keep you humble for sure, man. And it's great to have the kids that you grew up with being right by you and holding you down, and I have my back more than anything, so it's never too hard. They will ground you. Thanks for watching. See you later, MTV.